The search for life beyond Earth has been one of the most driving forces for interplanetary missions, with the most successful venture taking place around Jupiter and its moons. One of Jupiter's 53 moons is primed with data showing the presence of watery oceans beneath its surface, implying there's likely a presence of life out there. A vast ocean is thought to exist beneath the frozen surface of Europa. The Hubble Space Telescope has detected evidence of plumes erupting from this ocean in the past years, adding more speculation that life could exist on Europa. Europa Clipper is a planned NASA mission orbiting Jupiter and is equipped with scientific instruments for studying Jupiter's icy moon, Europa. Clipper will be the most advanced spacecraft ever sent to investigate the habitability of another world, with a sophisticated suite of scientific instruments. Its former official NASA name was the Europa Multiple Flyby Mission, but in 2017 it was officially renamed Europa Clipper. Clipper refers to the Clipper ships that sailed across the oceans of Earth in the 19th century. Three-masted sailing vessels renowned for their grace and swiftness. Europa Clipper will determine if Europa's ocean or overall environment is suitable to support some form of life. It will be the third spacecraft to orbit our solar system's largest planet, and the second to run on solar power at Jupiter's distance from the Sun. It will also be the first NASA mission to solely investigate a moon other than Earth's moon. The spacecraft is planned to launch in 2024 and arrive at Jupiter in 2030. At the launch, it will weigh around 13,000 pounds, 6,000 kilograms, with fuel accounting for about 65% of the total weight. Its solar panels will span approximately 100 feet, 30 meters, which is wider than the length of a basketball court. The spacecraft will pass by Mars and then Earth, stealing their orbital momentum. These gravity aids provide Europa Clipper with the speed it needs to get to Jupiter. Clipper will spend nearly a year in Jupiter's orbit, altering its trajectory in preparation for its Europa flyby. The spacecraft will then fly past Europa 45 times for 3 years. After each flyby, the spacecraft will relay data back to Earth. The probe will survey practically the entire moon at various resolutions throughout the mission. A metal box known as a radiation vault will protect the electronics from Jupiter's severe radiation. The walls of the vault are made of aluminum alloy that is roughly 0.3 inches thick. ASU scientists and engineers working on the Europa Thermal Emission Imaging System, EThemis, for NASA's Europa Clipper passed a major hurdle recently by capturing the first successful test images from this complex infrared camera known as First Light Images. EThemis is an infrared camera designed by Regents Professor Philip Christensen of Arizona State University's School of Earth and Space Exploration to map the temperatures of Europa for the mission. These infrared images will assist scientists in their search for clues regarding Europa's activity, including areas where Europa's suspected ocean may be close to the surface. A temperature image taken north from ISTB-4 is one of the most beautiful test images produced by EThemis. In spectacular detail, the image reveals ASU's Sun Devil Stadium and A Mountain, as well as other famous ASU landmarks. Based on temperature variations sensed from around 1.1 kilometers away, the EThemis equipment can even read details within the stadium. The EThemis crew took temperature images during this test throughout the afternoon and early evening. These images show how the temperature changes as nightfall approaches when presented in color. The red, orange, and yellow colors in the images indicate warmer temperatures, which are caused by heat and infrared radiation. Cooler temperatures are shown by purples and dark blues, with less heat and infrared radiation emitted. While the temperatures are estimates during this testing phase, the progression of cooler colors, purples and blues, from afternoon to evening in the three images obtained at 12:40 p.m., 4:40 p.m., and 6:20 p.m. after sunset, illustrates how the infrared camera detected surface temperatures moving from warmer in the afternoon to cooler after sunset. Following the successful first light testing of EThemis, the team will go on to the environmental testing to ensure that EThemis will survive launch and perform as anticipated in space. If you like this video, please consider subscribing and click the notification bell so you do not miss any upcoming videos.